Have you ever had the experience of waking up inside a dream where you're still asleep, but you suddenly realize that you're actually dreaming? What's up, guys? Today I'm here to explore lucid dreaming and how we can actually deliberately induce this state of being. So for those of you who are brand new to my channel, my name is Lucas, and my mission is to bring you the most cutting edge health information that you'll struggle to find on Google. So please like this video, smash subscribe below, and if you have any questions or comments, leave them down below and share your experience with lucid dreaming if you've ever lucid dreamed in the past. So ultimately, in today's video, what I'm going to do is explore a range of compounds, supplements, and drugs that can deliberately help one to achieve a lucid dream. Here's a little quick fact about lucid dreaming itself. For most individuals, lucid dreams spontaneously occur infrequently. However, there is a substantial variation in lucid dream frequency, ranging by current estimates from never approximately 40 to 50% of the population to monthly approximately 20% of the population to a small percentage of people that experience lucid dreaming 3 to 4 times per week, or in some cases every single night. I find this quite fascinating and would love to hear your experiences. Drop a comment below how often you remember that you're actually dreaming and you took control of your dream. So here I have my top 5 lucid dreaming drugs, supplements, and nootropics. So ultimately, this is not medical advice, just be aware. And bear in mind, I'm not encouraging people to combine all of these compounds. I'm just listing them from a range of compounds that can induce lucid dreaming by themselves. Well, ultimately we have a list of 5. So the very first one is huperzine A. Huperzine A I'll be exploring very shortly. Number 2, we have galantamine. Number 3, we have paracetam. Number 4, we have bacopa monnieri. And number 5, we have CDP choline or any other choline source. So first up, we have huperzine A. Huperzine A, I'm sure you've heard about in the nootropics community, but if you've never heard about what this particular ingredient or compound is, it's actually an alkaloid that's extracted from Chinese club moss, and it's been very well researched to improve memory, learning, and concentration, and specifically even stave off cognitive decline. And it has been studied in various population groups that are potentially struggling with the early onset Alzheimer's disease. So in terms of huperzine A and dosage, the key point to understand here is that huperzine A dosages are actually in the micrograms, not milligrams. So please don't make this mistake if you ever use huperzine A. Huperzine A, the recommended dosage is between 100 micrograms to 300 micrograms, not milligrams. To dose huperzine A, most people use it about 30 to 45 minutes before bed, and most people report very lucid dreams from just huperzine A alone. So you'll see a link to huperzine A and all of the other compounds mentioned in the description of this video below, so be sure to check out the links below. The next compound or drug that we have on our lucid dreaming stack list is galantamine. Now, galantamine is a well-researched drug to combat Alzheimer's disease. We can see here, this study was titled "Galantamine, a novel cholinergic drug with a unique dual mode of action for the treatment of patients with Alzheimer's disease." Now, the key point to note is that yes, galantamine shares a similar mechanism of action to huperzine A, but it is also considered an allosteric modulator of nicotinic acetylcholine receptors. So these receptors are actually what nicotine can activate and bind to, and these appear to play a crucial role in memory formation and can definitely stir on lucid dreaming states. So in terms of a dosage for galantamine, the most common dosages that are used for lucid dreaming purposes are between 2 milligrams to 4 milligrams. Now, this is not a compound you'd want to be using frequently, like every single day, as the acetylcholinesterase inhibition may build up and you may end up finding yourself pretty flat and depressed when you have too much acetylcholine floating around in your brain. In terms of a dosage strategy, keep the dosage low, and galantamine is being used for many other features or benefits outside the scope of lucid dreaming. Obviously, it is going to help with cramming for exams, studying, or just generally helping one with their short-term memory. So you'll see a link to galantamine in the video description below. And bear in mind, the dosage was 2 to 4 milligrams. The next compound we have is the old school classic nootropic, piracetam. Piracetam is truly the very first nootropic that has ever been sort of explored in the realms of cognitive enhancement. So we can see here, this study was titled Long-Term and High-Dose Piracetam Treatment of Alzheimer's Disease. Now, piracetam has been used to improve fluidity, verbal fluency, memory, concentration, focus, and learning. But piracetam does indeed also bind to the acetylcholine or increase acetylcholine production in the brain. And so many people have reported very vivid dreams with piracetam. So in terms of a dosage for piracetam, you're looking at anywhere between 800 milligrams to 1200 milligrams. And that can be used any time of the day, but you'd rather shift it back towards afternoon or after dinner. Next up, we have Bacopa monnieri. Bacopa monnieri is a traditional old school natural nootropic. Bacopa monnieri has been researched to improve memory formation, and many people also report lucid dreaming from Bacopa monnieri. It does share a similar mechanism to both huperzine A and galantamine. It does seem to inhibit acetylcholinesterase. And we can see this study was titled The Neuropharmacological Review of the Nootropic Herb Bacopa monnieri. So Bacopa can be found in the link video description below. A link can be found below. And in terms of a dosage, we're looking at between 250 to 300 milligrams of Bacopa monnieri. And this can also lower cortisol and generally improve serotonin production and help with sleep overall. So you're getting that double whammy of both potential lucid dreaming enhancement plus the benefits for sleep architecture as well. And then finally, we have CDP choline or any other choline source. CDP choline can be used for those who do not eat a lot of eggs, or they don't like eating egg yolks, or they don't eat other choline rich foods. So you can use CDP choline instead. So that's my go-to lucid dreaming kit. Obviously, I'm not encouraging people to combine all of these therapies or these compounds. Really, what I'm doing is sharing a range of different options to either start trialing, experimenting with, and seeing sort of which one works to improve the likelihood of lucid dreaming. Bear in mind, we don't want to be doubling up on too many of these ingredients, as they can have some deleterious side effects, such as excess acetylcholine, which is not a very nice feeling. So hopefully you learned something new. I'd love to hear your experiences with lucid dreaming. Drop a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you. If you're new to my channel, please check out all of my other amazing videos. I've got some really useful resources. Thank you for tuning in. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.